getting tired, Hobbs. This blanket fort is just way too comfy. Let's read one last book. Uno's Garden by Graham Bass. Uno's Garden. The animals go by one by one. 100 plants, then there were none. And all the while the buildings double. This numbers game adds up to trouble. But if you count with the utmost care, and trust me that they are all there, you'll go from 10 to nothing then, the whole way back to 10 again. Uno arrived in the forest on a beautiful day at the very beginning of spring. There to welcome him were 10 magnificent moopaloops. And one completely ordinary snortle pig. Uno loved the forest so much he decided to live there. Here we've got 10 moopaloops. 10 of each of these 10 plants for 100 plants. 0 buildings and 1 snortle pig. Uno climbed above the treetops. The forest seemed to go on forever. Swinging through the branches were 9 leaping lumpy bums and the completely ordinary snortle pig.
Where's the snortle pig, Hobbs?
Where is he? Found him. And 1 building. Big change in the forest. Others followed Uno. They loved the forest too. They built houses and boats, watched by 8 feathered Frinklepods, and the snortle pig, of course. Uno began to work on a little garden. Can you guys find 8 Frinklepods? 64 plants and 2 buildings. 1, 2. The fishermen's children played games among the trees. They counted 7 playful puddle butts plus 1 snortle pig. A little village grew. Where is the snortle pig? Where is he, Hobbs? Oh, I see him. He's hiding behind the rock. 4 buildings, 49 plants, 7 animals. Some hunters went into the forest looking for sneaky snaggle bites. There were 6, but the hunters didn't catch them, or the snortle pig. 6 snaggle bites, 36 plants. 8 buildings, 1 snortle pig. Where is he? Oh, I see his silhouette, buddy. There's Uno's house. Tourists came. They saw 5 timid tumble tops, but that was all. Uno kept working in his garden. The village became a town. 5 animals, 25 plants, 16 buildings. 1 snortle pig. Where is the snortle pig? He's hiding in the bushes. Then the railway was built. Excited passengers watched for the wild animals. They caught a glimpse of 4 grazing gondolopes. And what was that other funny looking creature back there? 1, 2, 3, 4. And a snortle pig. 32 buildings. That number got up quick. The town had become a city. A team of scientists arrived to study the animals. 3 flippered flipper flaps was all they found. Like what we did for third grade. There's our snortle pig walking away. The city grew bigger and bigger, and the forest grew smaller and smaller. Some workers came across 2 pointy pricklebacks. They had never seen anything like them. A lone fisherman set his line in the river. He caught a car tire, several old boots, and a cold. He didn't see the snortle pig. In fact, nobody had seen one for so long, people weren't even sure they existed. He's kind of faded there, buddy. Hmm. 1 snortle pig, 1 plant, 256 buildings, double from our last number, 128. Somewhere is Uno's garden. Oh, there it is, way in the corner. One gray morning, the people of the city woke up, looked out over the endless buildings, and were sad. Why do we live in a place like this? They asked themselves. There are no trees. So they left. No animals, no plants, lots of buildings. And Uno's house. There in the middle, there's his flag. The city was dark and abandoned. Uno opened his door and looked out. Sitting there in the garden, among the plants that Uno had saved, was a snortle pig. Completely ordinary in every way, except that it was there. The snortle pig lived in Uno's garden for many years. The city crumbled, forgotten. The snortle pig grew old and died. So did Uno, but the garden lived on. One leafy tree, one old shack, one snortle pig. Uno's children continued to care for the little collection of trees and plants, and slowly the forest returned. The children kept a diary of their discoveries. Two pointy pricklebacks. We've got all their lists, but no snortle pig. Three flipper flaps, but no snortle pig. Four grazing gondoloops. No snortle pig. Five timid tumble tops. Over the years, Uno's grandchildren added to the list. Six sneaky snaggle bites. Seven playful puddle butts. Their grandchildren added to the list too. Eight feathered frinkle pods. Nine leaping lumpy bums. Ten magnificent moopaloops. And on a beautiful day at the very beginning of spring, the forest and the city found themselves in perfect balance. 100 animals, 100 plants, and 100 homes. Bet we could count them all, Hobbs. Stories were told of the days when an extraordinary creature had lived in Uno's garden. The children listened with wide eyes, and they never stopped believing that one day they would see a real, live snortle pig for themselves. A question of balance. Getting the balance right is not always easy, especially between what people need and what nature needs, and it's surprising how quickly things can change when you're not looking. A gradual decrease on one hand with a small but accelerating increase on the other can add up to big differences. The numbers game in Uno's garden shows how this can happen. The animals numbers game is the most straightforward, simple subtraction, one at a time, a steady countdown from 10 to 0. The plants number game is another countdown, but this time, in a reducing series of squares. A square is what you get when you multiply a number by itself. For example, 3 times 3 is 9, so 9 is the square of 3. Here we see big numbers getting very small quickly. The buildings number games shows what happens when numbers are doubled. A tiny increase at first, but accelerating, resulting in a dramatic change. So when Uno's children have the chance to start over, they are very careful to keep the numbers game under control, because in the end, it's all a question of balance. By the way, if you're wondering about the number of people in each picture, in the first half of the book, it's the first 10 prime numbers. In the second half, it's the same number of rediscovered animals. Guys, that was Uno's Garden by Graham Bass. I love this book, especially this time of year because it's spring here in Georgia. And we just had Earth Day, just kind of an important day to help us remember that we need to take care of this earth. It's the only one we have. And we can help out all of the plants and the animals in the world, or we can hurt them. And we just have to balance what we need with what the plants and animals need too. And I hope that you guys are getting outdoors on this super weird break of ours. And I look forward to seeing you all soon. Good night. Sleep tight.